A new $10 million campaign to change the way children and teens with mental health issues are treated in Southwest Florida.
6 months ago, the NBC2 investigators exposed a mental health crisis among children living in Lee and Collier counties. We told you about a huge spike in the number of them being involuntarily committed for psychiatric care. Investigator Rachel Polanski broke that story and continues her coverage with what may be the solution.
Under Florida's Baker Act, children can be placed on psychiatric holds by licensed mental health providers or law enforcement officers. Over the last 5 years, juvenile Baker Acts have increased 136% in Lee County and 170% in Collier County. Local officials tell me that this new initiative will reduce those numbers.
This looks like your typical press conference.
We really want this to be a community issue that we can all gather around.
But it's not.
That's our responsibility.
This is Lee Health and Golisano Children's Hospital rolling out our region's new approach to children's mental health care.
It's a big deal for us in Southwest Florida because this has been one of the poorest performing states in the country, and within Florida, actually one of the poorest performing regions.
That's John Chomo, the Chief Population Health Officer at Lee Health. And he's right. Florida ranks 49th in per capita spending for mental health, and Lee County is among the worst funded counties in the state.
We really haven't been addressing teen anxiety, teen depression, and teen substance use disorders. And the cognitive behavioral therapy that we're investing in for pediatrics treats those specific behavioral and mental health issues.
This new initiative called Kids Minds Matter will include more early intervention services, more inpatient and outpatient care, and new training and education for those who work with kids.
It helped me in a way to open my eyes.
Kids like 15-year-old Sarah Darty, who we told you has been committed under the Baker Act twice.
I just remember, like, I'm being, like, so sad about everything.
I was cleaning her room, and I got the wake-up call as a parent.
Do you think these new resources and services will curb the number of kids being Baker Acted in Lee County?
Yeah, we believe it will. In other communities that have had similar issues with teens being Baker Acted, what they found is that where you've got outpatient services aligned with your inpatient in a coordinated care model, you can change the outcomes of those teens before they become a problem.
And would you say this is long overdue?
Absolutely.
Child advocate Richard Keelan has high hopes. Remember when I said there would be new training for those who work with kids? He's the one that will be doing that training.
We have this first aid and CPR for all the medical issues, but no one knows how to deal with mental health.
I asked him if I could watch him work, and he invited me to his mental health first aid training at Florida Southwestern State College.
We give them the ability to understand mental health issues, put it in a context, and be able to make up a 5-point plan in order to help that child or help the adult.
If you've ever taken a CPR first aid course, Keelan says his class is a lot like that, except he's talking mental health.
For L, listen carefully and looking for nonverbal cues through his body language. It really allowed us to put ourselves in the shoes of people who may not think the same way that we do, but how we can help them and using language that doesn't have a stigma attached to it.
The class includes a lecture, a discussion, and a number of hands-on activities.
Mental health first aid, you're not clinicians, you're not diagnosing. It's not your job. You're noticers, you're trying to help, and you're trying to get them to help themselves or get them to people where they need to be if it's in a crisis situation.
And trainings like Keelan's are a small part of our region's big plan to treat the 46,000 Southwest Florida children, like Sarah, who struggle with their mental health.
There's so many kids out there that just don't even know what mental illnesses even are. There's so many parents out there and adults that don't even know what it is.
It could be your child. It could be your child.
Last year, Kids Minds Matter raised more than $3 million. I was told that money has gone into training local pediatricians, addressing college students with a focus on suicide prevention, and offering more courses like mental health first aid to our community. For more information on Kids Minds Matter or on our investigation into juvenile Baker Acts, click on the NBC2 News app. For the NBC2 Investigators Tonight, I'm Rachel Polanski.